Let's start with the session for the projections of planes, where plane is a two-dimensional graphic element having length, width, and negligible thickness. Based upon orientation, planes are classified as perpendicular planes having their surface perpendicular to one of the reference planes and parallel or inclined to the other reference plane. Second is an oblique plane having their surfaces inclined to both reference planes. Now, let's study the projection of a plane ABCD, which is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. Observe the diagram carefully. The projector lines from C and D extended through A and B meets the HP in points DA and CB respectively. The lines DA, CB is the top view and the horizontal trace HD of the object. Since the plane is parallel to VP, there will be no vertical trace of the object. This is the visualization of a projection in three-dimensional space. So now we will proceed with actual drawing on paper. First, draw a horizontal reference line XY. Then, draw a rectangle A', B', C', D' of the same size as ABCD above the line XY on VP at a height of 8 units. This is a front view. Then draw a horizontal line DACB at a height of D units below and parallel to line XY, which is the top view. Now consider another case where the plane ABCD is located in the first quadrant as its surface is inclined at angle theta to VP and perpendicular to HP. As we can see, the front view is A', B', C', D' and the top view is DACB. Let's illustrate its construction in detail. For this, first locate point DA below the reference line XY at D1 units. Measure an angle theta and locate point CB at D2 units. Then draw a line DACB. From these points, draw vertical lines to meet XY and extend them further for a distance of 8 units to get points A' and B'. Next, extend it further, locating points D' and C'. Observe, by joining all these points, we'll be getting the front view as A', B', C', D'. Now, what will be the construction of projection when rectangular plane surface is inclined at an angle of 60 degrees with the HP and 30 degrees with the VP? For this, let's go through the steps. First, the plane is assumed to be parallel to HP with its longer edge perpendicular to VP. Then, observe the diagram for step 1. The true shape and size of the plane is given by its projection on HP. The front view will be a true line parallel to reference line XY. Next, in step 2, rotate the front view projection by angle of 60 degrees. Draw vertical lines from points A'B' and D'C' to intersect horizontal lines drawn from the top view of step 1, ABCD, at points B1, C1, D1 and A1. A1, B1, C1, D1 is the top view of the plane when inclined at 60 degrees with HP. Now, rotate the edge B1, C1 of the top view by angle of 30 degrees as step 3. Draw projections from A1, B1, C1 and D1 to intersect the horizontal projections from D'C' and A'B' to get the points A2', B2', C2' and D2'. Observe A2', B2', C2', D2' is the final front view of the given plane surface when inclined 30 degrees with the VP. And that's it. We have successfully completed with the chapter of points, lines and planes. So let's take a quick recap. In this chapter, we learned how to project geometrical elements at different orientations with reference to a right angle principal planes.
अगर आप भी मेरा मनोबल बढ़ाना चाहते हो तो इस वीडियो को लाइक ज़रूर करें, शेयर करें अपने फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली के साथ, इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब जरूर करें। थैंक यू सो मच। जय हिंद।